looking at different people who survived crazy situations that they probably shouldn't have. Cause they survived the impossible. Literally. Don't know what I'm talking about? Oh, family, just wait, let's find out. Before we start today's video, smash like, smash subscribe, and comment down below something crazy that's happened to you this week, and I'll pin my favorite comment. Craziest thing that happened to me this week is that I got to eat 3 chocolate bars in a row, and I didn't even throw up! Progress. The first person we got is a guy named Aaron Ralston, and he got stuck inside of a giant canyon when he was on a climbing trip alone. He was climbing the canyon and then slipped and fell into a big hole. But then a giant boulder fell on his hand, and his hand literally couldn't come out. It was stuck. That boulder did not want to let go of that dude's hand. Like, yeah, okay, boulder, I know you think the guy is cute, but you gotta let go of his hand at some point. Spoiler alert, he didn't. And the only way that Aaron could get out of that rock was by chopping off his hand. I wish I was kidding, but I'm not. So after 5 days, he finally got out, jumped off of a 65-foot wall, and walked 7 miles to find another family who was camping with their kids? Mama? You sure you want to go there? I don't think a baby can hold a bottle with no hands. The family gave him food and water, and he was finally brought back to safety. Except his hand, that is. Yeah, that thing's still wandering somewhere in the rock. This crazy guy named Paul Rosalie volunteered himself to get eaten by an anaconda. And not no regular anaconda, a giant one. He got into some crazy morph suit that's supposed to fight off snakes and protect him from fully getting eaten. I don't know, whatever it was, it didn't work. Cause when the snake started wrapping himself around the dude, apparently the guy could literally feel his arms breaking. And then he started to panic. The people who were filming him went to go help him. But I don't know why, because if you ask me, but he volunteered himself in the first place. This was all your idea, Paul.
And now you wanna take it back?
Nah. It don't work like that. I'm gonna keep filming and not stop until I see that snake swallow you whole. A promise is a promise.
I don't care about the rules.
Meet our boy Carlos. And no,
this photo is not Photoshop, unfortunately.
And no, this is not a photo of a balloon with half the air sucked out.
This is a real person.
Also, unfortunately,
a real person, a real head,
and a real skull that's been smacked down by the pavement from falling out of a truck in a car accident. The guy's name is Carlos Rodriguez, but on the streets he goes by Halfy. Y'all can put that together yourselves. During the accident, Carlos flew through the window of the car and landed straight on his noggin. And the only way he could survive was after 20 different surgeries, and the doctors had to take away half of his brain. But he went from IQ 50 to negative 50 real quick.
They're probably smarter than me, though.
I was barred out on drugs. I was driving and I hit a pole and flew out the front window and landed on my head.
Dang, Carlos. At least he stuck the landing, though.
But he really aced that one. But don't ask him about his future math tests. Those didn't go so well. This dude, Todd Orr, was strolling through a forest where he happened to come along a mama bear and her cub. Before he could even react, mama bear charged for him and bit him on his arm and his neck. The mama bear then left, and Todd ended up making a run for it to his car. But after 10 minutes, the mama bear caught back up with them and bit him again. Twice on the arm and twice on the neck.
Jeez, mama, chill.
But he was just trying to sightsee some birds, and you had to go all crazy on him.
Jeez, Karen.
Calm down. Todd finally got back to his car, all kinds of messed up, and had to go in emergency surgery the next day. But family, there's a bright side to this story. Todd ended up filming a video about the whole situation, and it ended up getting 20 million views on YouTube after the first day.
I don't know, Mama Bear's breakfast could go viral like that.
This guy, Jose, was stuck at sea for over 400 days. He went out on a fishing trip with his buddy, and then after a crazy storm, the boat kind of just broke, and they got lost. Stuck in the middle of the ocean with nothing to eat except raw fish and some turtles.
Turtles! Man, that's just sad.
They also didn't have any drinking water left, so they were stuck drinking their, natural apple juice
and turtle blood.
Again with the turtles, the heck? After 300 and some days, his buddy ended up getting real sick from eating all the raw fish, and he kinda you know? But Jose promised that he wouldn't eat his buddy's body as food, so then ended up talking to the lifeless body on the boat instead. But then after a while, he thought he was going crazy, so he tossed his buddy's body overboard. Like, see ya, buddy, goodbye. Nice knowing you. But I guess not that nice, because buddy threw him back in the water just like you throw back a fish after you gone fishing. He didn't even think about it. Jose eventually drifted towards a piece of land and eventually found civilization again. Only took him around 400 days. Or 7 dog years. Cause buddy's looking scruffy like a German shepherd. This guy named Tony Duncan fell off of a moving train and literally almost got his whole body sliced in half. Well, technically he was cut in half because
his legs went bye-bye.
Yeah, they gone.
The lower half of his body was dangling off the train and eventually he ended up falling underneath the train and y'all can picture the rest. Somehow he ended up calling 911 and after 20 or so surgeries,
he survived.
Well, he did, but his height definitely didn't. He went from 6'4" to no feet 3.
Yeah, that's short.
But anyways, family, that is all of the people who survived crazy things that I have for you today. If you liked today's video, smash like and smash subscribe. And go follow me on my Instagram if you're not already. I love you all so much. And I'll see you all in my next video.